So, lyrics for My Violent Heart. You and I, we may look the same, but we are very far apart. There's bullet holes where my compassion used to be, and there's violence in my heart. Into fire you can send us, from the fire we return. You can label us a consequence of how much you have to learn. You can try, but you'll never understand. This is something you will never understand. Can you hear it now? Hear it coming now? Can you hear it now? On hands and knees we crawl. You cannot stop us all. Our bones, our skin, we will not let you in. You have set something in motion, much greater than you've ever known, standing there in all your grand naivete, about to reap what you have sown. Time will feed upon your weakness, and soon you'll lose the will to care. When you return to the place that you call home, we will be there, we will be there. What perspective do you think this is from? Because you know how he's saying, like, these songs are all from different perspectives in this world of the future? Doesn't seem like those in power. I like this groove. Excuse me.
You and I, we may look the same, but we are very far apart. There's bullet holes where my compassion used to be, and there is violence in my heart. Into fire you can send us, from the fire. Can label us a consequence of how much you have to learn. You can try, but you'll never understand. This is something you will never understand. Can you hear it now? Hear it coming now.
Oh, God.
This song ends, it almost makes it seem like it's supposed to be in a DJ set. It's like a long outro like that. Atmos keys on the top. Let's see what that is. That's a cool sound. So distorted. Okay. So it's like a crunchy layer, and it's just kind of droning on a B-flat. So song's in B-flat. Okay. Attack, etc. drum. Okay, so that's the kick. Yeah, so there's just like one kick kind of at the beginning of each measure there. So lots of like high-end stuff. Okay, now this... sounds like so much like a loop that I would have found in like that program I had, maybe like Acid Pro. It's kind of a little bit, I wish I could remember all the terms for all electronica subgenres, all the beats. It's a little bit hip-hop, but it's something else. Wish Melody were here, she would know. But yeah, that's like so distorted. Okay, what's this? I do like that part. Remember, this is like kind of a bridge. And we have that kind of freaking out. Guitars, maybe. I'm not sure if they're real guitars. But and we get this one moment where we get a cool delay. Because this is all very dry. There's no... there's any reverb on it, I can't detect it. You know, there's no delay of any kind. But then we get this. It's a great example of how adding a delay with a cool rhythm can create some like secondary rhythms that are really neat. So that's on every dotted eighth note. So it cycles in three against two. It's Hemiola thing or three against four. I can't remember sometimes which one is two and which one's four. Yeah, three against two. Hemiola. Okay. Boom. Okay. All right, so that's kind of the foundation of the drums, but that's not all the like sounds. So, okay, what's basses? Basses. Is there more than one bass? Yeah, so. This is like slightly funky. Just the tone. Like, it could totally be in a funk song, and it's just a flat 7 to 1. That's all you need. That's the extent of the harmonic movement in this song. Wow. That's tasty. That's very tasty. Very fat. Okay, guitars. Ooh. Freaky vocals pitched down. So it's also droning on B flat, just higher. It's very haunting sounding. It's very film score-y. Like just that alone could be in a film score, right? Okay. I'm curious if anybody else hears this the way I do. It's pretty chaotic, but there is a pattern and it just keeps repeating. And there's these accented pitches that are high up that kind of create almost like a little melody So it's a... kind of. Which is also just A flat and B flat, so that's what the bass is doing. So, I think it's melodic, a little bit, a little bit. Okay, let's go check out what happens when it freaks out, though. That's so cool. I don't know how he did that. I can't even tell, because I know he did a lot of this in Ableton. I don't know if that those are Ableton guitars or if he's actually played guitar and then he's mangling them, but that's that this already sort of mangled sound. But mangled even further. So I like that freak out part. All right. We got another drum loop to check out. I think this is the high end of the drums. And this. So the drums in My Violent Heart, God Given, and Zero Sum, there are some tracks that are the same. And they just change the tempo. God Given, I think, is exactly the same tempo as My Violent Heart, or one BPM slower or faster. And then Zero Sum is a lot slower. But they use the same bones of the drum grooves. So I thought that was kind of a cool continuity thing. I remember first hearing Year Zero and thinking that, how neat it was to like recognize the drum loops, but in a different song. And knowing full well that he did that intentionally just made it kind of exciting, you know, like I'm hunting it down. Like, oh, I heard that before. And there's another sample. Kai was talking about this. There's a sample in God Given and Zero Sum of maybe an orchestra or something from a movie. And it plays kind of this haunting dominant seventh chord. And it's in both those songs. So there's all sorts of, you know, tie-ins. But yeah, I think this exact loop is used in God Given, except that the drum, the kick drum is on every beat in God Given. So we'll get to that. This is a cool groove. I like this groove. I think, it reminds me a little bit of Prodigy. They're Prodigy, sorry. Cool. What's happening over here? Ooh. Hard pan to the right. That so intense. It's like machine gun. Tambourine. Okay, this is the first time I realized there's definitely tambourine in the song. There it is. Okay, I'm kind of curious, what does the song sound like without the tambourine? Sometimes I like tambourine. Sometimes I don't. I'm just curious. Yeah, I'm not my favorite. That's okay. Extra shit. Let's listen to extra shit, shall we? Shit, shall we? Oh my god. What the fuck? Okay, I was not aware of this layer. That's so creepy. What is that from? What is that? Okay, we're gonna mute the tambourine and the extra shit and see if we can detect the absence of it. Yeah, that is buried. That's so creepy. Sounds like they took some sample from something that had flutes and some, maybe it's like a, from a, like an old 60s film or something where someone's singing a note and they just slowly pitch it down. That's my guess. Wow, that's demented. That is demented! Okay. All right, let's check out the vocals and then we'll move forward. Vocals. So we got background vocals and lead vocals. Okay, so lead vocals.
You can label us a consequence.
He's got that effect on his voice that he has sometimes.
Of how much you have to learn.
It's like a little bit like he's talking through something
you
muffled.
Can try, but you'll never understand.
Okay, so now this is a melody here. You can try, but you'll never understand. It's very Trenty because it's all flat seven. Ugh. I just realized I can use this song to demonstrate a minor seventh descending for one of my projects for February that you will benefit from if you want to become a better musician. This is an example of a one chord song, by the way. I mean, it doesn't even really have a chord, but like it doesn't move away from B flat. Okay. So this is nice in octaves.
This is something you will never understand. Can you hear it now? Hear it coming.
Okay, I'm gonna
now.
Mute the background.
Can you hear it now? On hands and knees, we crawl. You cannot stop us all. Our bones, our skin. We will not let you in.
Oh, that's terrifying. He's duplicated his voice and then done some, like, put some alien effects on it. So it's like, yeah, like a little bit, Gollum-like. Listen.
Bones are skin.
Skin.
We will not let you in.
Wait.
We crawl, you cannot stop. Crawl, you cannot.
I guess personally, I still can't understand why he chose to vocalize this way for this song. Like, why not write a melody? It's interesting, but I want to know why.
Stop us all, never leave our hands and knees.
Voice crack. All right, on hands and knees, indeed.
We crawl.
I don't think I recognize
our
that.
We crawl.
That's cool. Wow.
We crawl.
Interesting.